go on, Tata Cleantech. So that is from a financier's point of view now. Okay. So financiers obviously take precedence over everybody else.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sirsanath Banerjee. I'm from Tata Cleantech Capital. You may have heard of the company. For the benefit of those who haven't, this is joint venture between Tata Capital and IFC Washington. We are a infra-finance company, and again, infra-financing is a specific license accorded by RBI, which allows us to fund at specific terms to companies which can be companies or projects which can be classified under the infrastructure segment. The Tata Group, I guess, needs no introduction, but back in 1868, it was formed by Jamshedji Tata and cuts through industries. We have over 100 companies with group revenue of over 100 crores, a combined market cap of over 130 billion, I beg your pardon, and employees extensively across the globe. Well, again, we have 29 listed entities with combined market cap of close to $130 billion and also accorded with the coveted status, I would say, of one of the most valuable companies in India. Tata Capital is the financing arm of the group. Broadly, our whole asset book size today is close to 60,000 crores. Cuts through retail, commercial, and infrastructure loans. And as you can see from the slide here, we also have a private equity business, investment banking business, and clean tech finance, which is, again, something which is not you know, very commonly found in banks or financial institutions. We have a entity which is focused on only clean tech financing. As I explained, this company started as a clean tech financier. We were subsequently awarded the license to go ahead and do other infrastructure. So as of now, we are financing roads, transmission, hospitals, any other projects which fall under the ambit of infrastructure. Broadly, we have four businesses within Tata Cleantech. Credit and underwriting, which is essentially the asset book that I was talking about. Financial advisory. We have a full suite of financial advisory solutions, right from advisory on the buy side, sell side of M&As. We have done a lot of M&As already. I'll be touching upon that subsequently. We have a clean tech advisory division with specialist experts from TCE and other esteemed organizations who provide comprehensive advisory solutions to companies which want to start up in the clean tech space or also who are already there but want to expand. In the syndication side, we get a lot of inquiries for larger ticket loans which we may not be able to write a single check to, for whom we provide a one-stop solution to offer a syndicated term sheet with various lenders. You might have heard about the deteriorating credit quality of banks, asset books, and especially public sector banks. Tata Cleantech prides itself for the fact that we have no delinquencies, we have no NPAs, and no events of delays also in the book that we have built. Having said that, this is a dynamic sector, and we do not, you know, we cannot see clearly what the future holds for us. But as of now, we are very, very strong, as our credit rating suggests, and also the fact that we are growing very rapidly. And given the whole kind of cautiousness that we see in the sector, we are still one of the few lenders who are aggressively wanting to build a book in the renewable energy space, wind, solar, distributed generation, notwithstanding. A little bit about the team here. So we have a very good credit policy in place, which is pretty much a reflection of the strong values that the team brings in, which is, again, built from various large infra finance companies and large banks across states here. I touched upon financial advisory and M&A. To give you a perspective, we are in investment advisory, capital raising, and M&A. And we have done a few works which I would rather like to touch than these slides. So we have recently concluded a 110 megawatt solar M&A assignment, where we were advising on the sell side. And right from bringing in the investors to term sheet negotiations and closing the deal at its whole, we were there throughout the life cycle, and we are very happy with the way the deal transpired and added another happy customer to our list. We also have a lot of experience in bid advisory. Recently, we had concluded a bid advisory for a particular player from Saudi Arabia, from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, who wanted to enter India and wanted specific advisory services from a financial like Tata Cleantech. Cleantech advisory, again, we'll probably get to touch upon this more as we interact. This is customized for smaller developers who want to start up, who have ambitions to start a business in this space, but do not have the requisite connections, probably. Being an IFC company, we are connected to various players, right from the ecosystem of technical companies to financiers to investors. We can help you out there, and we'll be very happy to look into what we can do for you. We also have a specialized SEMS team. Being an IFC company, we have to abide by the EHSS principles of IFC. And this team takes care of all the environmental and social responsibilities of the companies to projects that we are financing. We also offer SEM services to companies which we are not financing. So in case you are looking to perhaps raise private equity money or look at outside investments, we'll be very happy to help you with the SEMS due diligence. This is a brief snapshot of the way Tata Cleantech has grown over the last 4 years. You'll see CAGRs of probably double or even triple digit figures here, and we expect to go much higher from here. I do not want to touch upon the industry information too much, but broadly, we are aligned to the targets given to the nation. As we speak, I think solar has increased to about 16 gigawatt and not 12 anymore, and we are right up there to help you reach your targets. Before I close in, I also had a couple of slides on Maharashtra specifically, but probably we'll discuss that in the panel. I wanted to make a small announcement. If you have heard of the SBI World Bank line or the PNB ADB line, I'm very happy to also inform you that Tata Cleantech is in advanced stages of talks with a global fund, and we'll soon be having a line of our own which can be used by all of you for rooftop projects. And please let us know. This line should be active in a month or 2 months' time, and you'll probably get rates as competitive as the other lines, and terms, the best possible terms that we can offer. Right. Thank you so much for your time. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you so much. That was very informative, and we look forward, especially the developers, on more news about the fund as and when it's out. Okay, so who's going? You want to go next? Amit?
Good morning, everybody. My name is Amit Thussu, and I'm the regional director for KACO New Energy in India. It's a German inverter manufacturer. So we have our manufacturing facility in over three continents, which would be Germany, US, and also in Korea. Korea, we manufacture our central inverters from the range of 500 kilowatt to 2.2 megawatts. In Germany, we manufacture inverters in the range of 3 kilowatts to a range of 125 kilowatts on string inverters. And for US, we have a separate manufacturing facility. In India, we operate from Delhi NCR, and we have our service centers also over here. Now, a brief about KACO. KACO was founded in 1914, so it is a more than 100-year-old company. And in 1958, there was a management buyout. And from that time, it is KACO New Energy. It is based out of Neckarsulm. In the short form, it is called NSU. It is the same place where Audi cars are manufactured. So about 80% of people in Neckarsulm drive Audis and are working at Audi. We are the only other company that actually survives there. Now, KACO has 98% of its focus on string inverters. We don't have any other verticals that we consider. So it is either string or central inverters that we make. Now, without the presentation, it becomes difficult. So let me go through this. Now, sorry about this. Okay, the gentleman you see in blue over here, okay, this is Ralph Hoffman, who did the management buyout, and he is still the managing director at KACO New Energy. Now, I'll go through the product solutions really fast, and then I'll end this. My apologies for the technology mismatch. Okay. The first series of inverters, 3 kilowatt to 5 kilowatt single phase, and we have the same series in three phase inverters as well, okay, and 3 kilowatt to 10 kilowatt in three phase. Now the 15 and the 20 kilowatt, I'm really going through it very fast, okay, need to talk about one or two products. Now this is one of our most hot selling products. This is the 50 kilowatt inverter. One of the major advantages of this inverter is that you can load it up to 40%. So on DC side, you can punch it up to 70 kilowatts, okay? And it still works. Okay, going to the next one, we have multiple variants on this. Okay, if you see, you have basic M, XL, and XL Outdoor. XL Outdoor is a system that can be used near sea. So globally we have a very long coastline, so they have an advantage, so extra powder coatings, thicker wires and things like that. So this is managed with that. Now the new product that we are launching is the Blue Planet 125 inverter. Okay, it is a 70 kilowatt inverter and it has an output of about 100. On DC side, you can load it up to 50%. 125 kilowatt inverter, 198 kilowatt, it can be overloaded. 50% overloading, derating after 55 degrees. Okay, on the 30 kilowatt range, we have our older series, PowerDoor, where we have 39 to 72 kilowatt. Please note that this nomenclature is based on DC side. So a 72 kilowatt on DC side, and it has 20% overloading, so it is a smaller inverter. Now, we were talking about batteries, and I won't touch central inverters today, but we were talking about batteries and systems that can, for power storage. So we have been doing that for quite a number of years. What we have there is a system where we have from 5 kilowatt to 1 megawatt battery storage systems. 5 kilowatt system, this is the 5 kilowatt battery storage system. Please note that this is not an inverter. It is another storage battery management system. Okay, so it will charge and discharge the battery. It has to be applied after the inverter. So you have to have a solar inverter and then a system like this. Now, after this, what we have is a 50 kilowatt battery inverter system. Now this is one of the largest systems on basic home scale that you can get. Nobody else in the market has a 50 kilowatt inverter for battery. Now going above this, you have a 250 kilowatt system and a 1 megawatt system for the big parks where you can stabilize the power output. Now this is something that somebody was talking in the morning as well about. Along with this, we can have central inverters, we can give you solutions, containerized solutions, skid solutions. And one last thing that I would like to share. This is a new CPSS system that we have, central power string solution. Now, everybody wants central to save pricing, so we have something similar that we give out. Now, if you see there's a 50 kilowatt inverter, they can be put on a rack and we provide you with a complete containerized solution, which can give you the similar design features that are there in a central inverter. This helps out, gives you more MPPTs, redundancies are less, and power generation goes up a little higher. Okay, do I still have time? No, done. Okay, so this is it for me. Thank you for listening to me. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Amit. Despite the technical glitch, I think we kind of got the gist of the products that you were talking about.
Thank you.
You have a presentation, sir, please.
Hello. It's really nice to be here once again with Suryacon, and I believe it is doing an enormous job of bringing the industry with a perspective of what is happening, but also what should be happening. And I am very glad to be here with you all, because this is more than what is happening. We as a company focus on what is likely to happen. And this is where we are, and we always say that we empower a grain of sand to capture the power of sun, because we are present. Yeah, because we are present into all kinds of technologies which are associated with solar, and we have been in the solar PV solar space, that is, for more than two decades, and have been kind of from the beginning. In the beginning, of course, it was more of a laboratory kind of business with public sector undertakings who wanted to evaluate the at a very R&D level the solar modules and solar cells. So we have been associated from that stage, but at the moment we offer our services for installation of equipment meant for the upstream side, that is module, cell, and then wafer, and then so on and so forth for even the refining of silica. We believe that Make in India will make an impact, and soon we will be seeing some signs of India going up the value chain in solar manufacturing space. We are also present in very many other things, and we try to bring the newer technology options for the industry as a whole. We represent around 30 world leading manufacturers, and we have a very well equipped, knowledgeable team which has been trained at the respective technology headquarters of our principals. I believe we have been talking about tariffs, we have been talking about the scenario which is currently there, and is it a good scenario or a grim scenario, but I think it all depends on us. If we think that 2.45 rupees or so is the bottoming out of the tariff, we should rethink, because Saudi Arabia has gone in for as much as 2 cents, which is equivalent of about 1 rupee 40 paise. So we let's keep watching what all happens. But that only means that there is a need to sharpen our approach towards the business. And how do we do that? By keeping a tab of what are the trends and what are the opportunities which are coming up. We see ourselves as a role of being catalyst in the PV industry, where we can say that our importance could be akin to salt in a food dish. So it is important, but it is very small in quantity. Now, we believe, and it has been covered, I believe, in the morning as well by Sharma, that energy storage is here. I believe if it took about 5 years or 6 years for solar to become what it is today, I think energy storage might not take more than 2 years to be in the same commercially viable space. So this is one trend which we see. In fact, we are also hearing that there are certain bodies, regulating bodies, which might start making it binding, that if you want to go for a solar project, you have to have a certain element of storage, because that is the, and they might give incentive for that, in fact. They may make it mandatory, which looks very contradictory. They might make it mandatory on one side, and they might incentivize it on the other side, because again, the gains will be salutary for the system as a whole, because it will address the stability issue. Because as we also hear, another trend which is coming up is day-ahead prediction. So now when you talk about day-ahead prediction, if you have an energy storage in between, you really are having a shield to play with. So I believe on one side, with the technological advancements and the commercialization of because of high scale, and also because of the compulsions that are showing their initial signs already, energy storage will catch up much faster. Ground mounted system with increasing use of trackers. When we used to talk about trackers about 3 years ago, we found that it was a concept selling. Today it is a reality, but what I believe is that whatever these gigawatt levels which we are talking on ground mounted, I think the percentage of single axis tracker, because that's the most popular and the most viable one, perhaps will gain more currency as the time passes. The third thing which is happening, which is being talked about in a significant way in various quarters, is 1500 volt DC system. So now this is perhaps a little in contradiction to what Amphase is trying to convey about the system and the safety. I fully buy the argument that safety has to be of supreme importance, and when you handle higher and higher voltages in DC especially, you have to be very, very careful. But I'm sure the moment the system is introduced, the safeguards will follow, or will accompany, not follow, because it can't have a time lag on that. I also believe, this is my personal view, that the mid segment of inverters in central space will start losing the sheen, because now, as we saw, that if you look at string inverters, we rarely find now 100 kilowatt inverter, for example. Generally, it is 20, 30, 50 kilowatt. But 100 kilowatt is generally not on the scene. Likewise, we had about 5-6 years ago, ABB offering 250 kilowatt inverter. Now it's not there. Soon, 500 kilowatt and 1000 also are becoming like a dinosaur. Like, you know, so either we'll have a 30 kilowatt inverter in course of time, or we might have 2 megawatt or 3 megawatt. Siemens displayed it in Intersolar. Many of you would have seen it. Now, another area, we talk so much about the payback and the revenue generation, and I think one of the simpler things is module cleaning in time. And I think there's a lot of possibility of new technologies in module cleaning system coming up, which means it should be effective, it should be quick, it may be automated, it should consume less water. So all these issues will become quite important in course of time. Other area where we have not really in India given much importance, and that is likely to gain currency, could be plant performance analysis. Because today I consider this as a great opportunity for investment, because we have 1 megawatt projects of IREDA where people are still encashing with 17.91 rupees. And if you tell him that you can produce one more unit by some method, then he sees 17.91 rupees coming to him. But if it is Rewa, then he sees a gain of ₹2.50. So the sense is there, if you go for phase one, batch one, where there are a lot of mistakes which have happened and the plant performance is low. So plant performance asset is another opportunity as I see. We all know, and we have talked about it, huge jump in rooftop opportunities, and there are many players in that. And OPEX model, in my opinion, will continue to grow in tandem, because more and more people will come, and rooftop people particularly would be the users whose prime objective is as a consumer. So they don't perceive themselves as an investor, and therefore the OPEX will grow in momentum. Distributed solar, of course, this is what Enphase is. I think it's okay. I'll just take a minute more. So I think I'll quickly go through AC system, micro inverter fitted modules, which is what has been talked about. Rise in rooftop opportunities will give more pressure for higher efficiency, and modules will gain more and more in higher space for the high efficiency modules. So these are the opportunities. Quickly, I'll go. High efficiency cells and modules have a better future. Simplified tracker system, floating solar system, innovative financing, plant performance analysis, O&M business, and plant performance insurance, distinctly different from analysis, and EV charging stations. These are the areas we can play a role in all of them. If somebody wants us to give a report or working out a thing, we have done an analysis as to how a good module turns into a bad module because of loss of fill factor. Just to give you an idea, we have also done a project with 500 kilowatt solar tracker, and we believe now that even for smaller capacities, trackers will gain traction. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That was very interesting, and you covered a very diverse range of issues, challenges, concerns, the future of actually an industry that is really, really very vast and diverse in a very short time. Thank you so much.